step-by-step interview guide. First of all, we'll start with the general tips for interview. Then we'll talk about what are the typical questions which are being asked. Then we'll see some behavioral questions also and how to deal with them. General tips. First of all, you want to visit an interview site, do it one day earlier. Map your route. Attire is must. Whatever you are wearing is the information you are providing them at the first glance. So your dress should be very good and should be abiding by that situation. Whatever achievements you have, just try to remember them. It should be fresh in your mind, because once you are speaking, it should just come out very swiftly. Know your answers to probable questions, because most of us are aware what questions are being or they are going to be asked. They are being asked or they'll be asked. Then just practice, because if you answer the answers, your answers are based on practice. You don't have to think there, right? Then you can use some aid like the video recorder. Now we have mobiles also. You can see your non-verbal communication. Then the image you are projecting in front of the interviewer, it can make your deal, it can break your deal. Then you may be asked to ask questions. So just prepare those questions. Don't ask about your salary. Just ask about what products you have, how my skills will be employed. So first of all, you need to know yourself and what you need to offer, what you have in offer to the company. The position and you are the match or not. And you need to know about the organization you are visiting, like you are visiting IBM. You need to know the history and the benefits you are going to add upon. Then you need to have a very, very good professional resume, very concrete, precise, and full of your achievements. Then again, for everything you need practice, because practice makes a man perfect. The dresses, as I said, is very important. You should look like someone who is very serious about the job. Probable questions, which includes the behavioral questions, you need to prepare them. Try to smile, make eye contact, and your handshake should be firm. And as I said, be on time. Just remember, the organization is hiring you because they need you. They want you. So that thing should be kept in your mind. There are certain legal and illegal questions, especially if we talk about Western countries. We need to know what are legal and illegal. Means we need to know the rights before we can appear to the interview. Arrest, police record, sex, disability, age, military service, race, childcare, religion, natural origin, and marital status. The question based on these are concerned or considered to be illegal. Like the question, that is an unusual name. Are you Polish or any other nationality? Would you have trouble working for a supervisor who is younger than you? Then you look 40, 50. Are you? These are all illegal questions. Then, do you have children? The job requires frequent overnight travel. Do you have family obligations? Illegal questions. Have you ever been arrested? In which branch of military? If you are in a country which requires you to put some time in military, these are illegal questions. I see you grew up in some locality. Are you you're trying to come up with a caste or creed? Will your disability prevent you from bending and stooping? These are illegal questions. There are certain typical and not so typical questions, because we are aware what needs to be answered, but we are aware generally what questions are going to be put in front of us. For example, tell me about yourself. Your answer should be very crisp, to the point. Don't ramble, just focus on those things which makes you qualified for that job. Then what are your strengths? Strength, because you have to make a list prior to entering the interview. The strength should be such that it is beneficial for everyone. And the weakness is what you think is as a weakness, but it should not portray your weakness. Say, I get very angry every time, I am not a team player. This weakness is actually a weakness, but you don't designate lot of job. That is weakness, but that is good for the company. Then how would your current boss describe you? Just be honest and don't ever speak anything against anyone. Describe the attributes of the worst boss. Now here they are trying to find out what you are going to answer, because worst boss means you have to give his or her negative attribute that you don't do. If there is any conflict or disagreement, how you are going to deal with it? How do you react to any criticism or any backbiting? Give an example of risk you have taken and what was the result, what was the outcome, how it turned out to be. You have to prepare. These things should be written prior. What is your managerial style if you are going in managerial position? What do you want to leave, or means why are you leaving the current employer? Be positive. You can say that I have done a lot of work, I have understood, I have learned also. Now I want to learn more, that is why I want to join your company. And what is your most important contribution of that previous employer? This you should know. Then what accomplishment in your life you are most proud? You have to know this, you have to write this so that you can present it. Would you hire you for this job? Why? If you are good, you are bad, you have to be very careful in answering this. Why should they hire you? And why should they hire you among all the people who have gathered there for the interview? You have to be very precise on that. Then what motivates you? You say, listening to Shakira song, that will not give a good impression. What motivates you is what you have studied, what your skills are, and how do you motivate others. That means you have to motivate the others also. Then we have behavioral based interviewing. This is totally based on the behavior. What are the questions that can be put in? What are the answers you need to give? Just see. Behavioral, that is the skill can be coping. The question could be something like this. Describe a high pressure situation you have handled at say school, work, or your previous department. What happened, who was involved, and what did you do in terms of resolving that issue? Then the skill could be tolerance of ambiguity. The question can be given an example of a time when you had to deal with frequent and unexpected changes. That is, something is changing very fast. What does this say about your ability to work in this kind of situation, unstructured, ambiguous situation? Versatility. In certain situation, as in life, we have to compromise. So tell me something that you actually compromised and the effect it has given or put in your life. Energizing, which comes under leadership, energizing and team building. You can be asked, like, you give an example of a time when you showed your positive attitude, or that positive attitude caused other to motivate and energized. Be very specific, because you are going to work in a team, so building a team spirit to get results is often difficult. Just tell how you are going to maintain this team spirit. Are you a team animal? Means you can work in a team. Influence means what are your influencing property? Can you speak well? Are you good in attracting people, or your content is so crisp and you say so well that in certain scenario you can get away from some some sort of inconvenience scenario, problem solving. Because whenever you are going for certain job, this problem solving, like the analytical and creativity, becomes very important. For example, you may be asked, give an example where you actively design several solutions to a single problem. Creativity, you may be asked, give a situation where you were inventive and you explored new ways of thinking and what was the result. Then problem solving also, decision making and decisiveness becomes very important. You may be asked, give an example of how you reached a practical business decision by an organized review of the facts, or taking different options in consideration. Also, give an example of situation where you have stood up for your decision, right? That would have made you unpopular. Now, personal working habits, that is commitment to the task. Just you can be very specific about describing a way how you were persistent to achieve that goal. Give an example of a specific time in which you found it necessary to give long hours, sit late in the night or come early in the morning. Then goals are very important in life. So what has been your experience in defining long and short range goals? And you may be asked, tell me what specific goal was set, how was it set, how successfully you achieved that. Then you can have the questions on personal working habits, like organization and planning, because every one of us, somewhere or the other place, we are involved in organization and planning. So you may be asked, many positions have well-established standard methods to help you do this job. Just give an example of a time when you found a systematic method for solving work problems to be a good routine to follow. And how did your planning help you to deal with this unexpected situation or scenarios? Then communication, because whenever you are working, the interaction becomes very important. So what you may be asked is, being skillful in dealing with others on the job is an important factor. Just describe a time when you were successful in dealing with some other person, because you build a trust and harmonious relationship. Then communication, in this we have spoken English, written communication. This spoken communication question can be like this. Tell about a specific time when your ability to listen helped you communicate better. Or tell about specific experience of yours that illustrate your ability to influence others verbally. Because careful listening and effective communication go hand in hand. Similar in the written communication. In certain jobs, it is necessary to document work thoroughly. You may be asked, give an example of a project you completed that required detailed written or documentation. What was the name of the document? So these are all very specific. You need to prepare, you need to practice. Just write it down and don't get upset if you're not selected, because the chances are immense. The companies are there for you and you will be good for some of them. So thank you so much. Take care of yourself.